Hello, welcome to Black Lake at Quantington again. Just going to do a bit of feeder fishing, hopefully to get some bream. Pretty simple mix today. I'm going to use the new feeder bream. Just two parts of this. As you can see, it is quite a pale mix, it's almost white. Here we then. So one part expander caramel. As I said in a previous video, you can mix fish meal with natural ground bait. One of them, and then top it off, just one part bram crumb. Mix all that together. As you can see, it's still a very light coloured ground bait. The reason for that is obviously I just want to catch bream today. I don't really want to be pestered with small fish and stuff. Additive is banana, or banana as it says, banana, yeah, banana. There is a powdered version of that too, but I just prefer using the liquid one at the moment. Very sweet. And as you would do, just little and often. With repeater mixes, you don't really want to mess them up before you start fishing. You've got to get it right. Does soak up quite a lot of water to start with. That feel about right. Just riddle it off in the bucket. Put the larger car particles back in there. Doesn't really matter in the summer. You just make sure it's all mixed in together, because there are some bits that are a bit drier than others. That'll do for now. Just let it soak in for about 20 minutes while I set my gear up. Then repeat the process. The rigs for today, pretty simple. It's got my MIDI reactor core XZ mini carp feeder rod, plastic 20 gram AS feeder from Feederland on a swivel, stopped by two number six slot shot, tiny little twizzle boom, a little loop at the end there for my hook length. Line is 6.6 pound MIDI MTech. That's basically all I need. I'm not fishing too far out, it's about 18 metres I think, possibly 20, I haven't really measured it to scale now, I've just plumbed the depth up and set it up. I will do it on the measuring sticks in a minute, but it's roughly about 18 metres. I'll put the hook length on when I'm finished feeding. I've just wet the mix for the third time, just going to riddle it off. It's a nice fluffy mix. So we get my working bowl. Just one of these. Just put enough in there for an hour or two. The rest back in your bucket. Put the lid on. Right, to this I'm just going to add some sinking crumbs. Like a handful of red. Same with the green one. Don't need to be wetted or anything, just put them in as they are. That's basically it. I'm just going to add some dead maggots and some corn and some worms as I go along when I'm feeding. Right, basically it. It's a simple grain of corn, let's hook it straight on. Couple of corn, a couple of grains in the ground bait. Fill it up. And there you go. My last fish was on the left of this, like I said before in a different video. I have a line of about 2 or 3 meters in length. If I catch a fish on the left, I'll generally go over to the right hand side, go in the middle just to see where the fish are. If you upset the whole shoal, then you're not going to catch much all day. I'm trying to pick them off different sections. I can see they're there, there's bubbles everywhere. One of the reasons why I bring sweet corn every time I go bream fishing. There's that many small fish there that would attack of the worm all the time, and just constantly using worms all the time, you're not going to get through them. But at some point you'll catch one or two bream, but if the roach are attacking the hook as soon as it hits the water, you've got no chance. If you stick a grain of corn on, it gets down past the small fish, straight to where the bream are, because most roach can't get the corn in the mouth anyway. And look, job done. Perfectly hooked in the lip. Maybe that's it. There it is. Nice fish. If the fish has hooked itself in the mouth, then you know your hook length's just about right. If you start having problems with it taking it too far down, then that's when you know you need to shorten the hook length. Or obviously if you're fishing the pole, change your depth. That's a bream. And a flying one at that. The hook's come out in a minute. Nice fish. I think it has anyway. Yes, it is. Back to using a single grain of corn. There's still loads of fish out there, you can see them all fizzing and bubbling. I'll just turn the camera a little bit. You might be able to see that. finding it easier to hook the fish with a slightly tighter line now. As before, set quite slack. Now set it quite tightened up. I'm getting bites and fish almost every 2 minutes now, so it's working quite well. But I've given up on worm now, because as soon as it lands, the roach are attacking it and absolutely obliterating the worm. So I've binned that idea. Cut out all the dead maggots. Probably put in a quarter of a tin of sweet corn just through the feeder. There's loads of fish there. Like that. Perfectly up in the lip. There he is.